In this heat, air conditioning trouble is an emergency. For immediate relief, call Enviro. Professional work done quickly and at a great price. Call anytime, 855-403-COOL.
Welcome, Tangi faculty and staff, to a new school year. You all look great after summer break, right? No, okay. I know we're all looking forward to this new year and all of the exciting challenges that come, even if those challenges including going back to the dark ages where your principal calls for a typewriter over the intercom. Anyways, as each day presents you the opportunity to pour into students' lives and to walk out your life's calling, I believe we're going to have a great year as you remember our motto, to be respectful, be compassionate, and be great. Next, I'd like to introduce you to Alexia Richardson from Amy High School.
Mrs. Cotton was stillborn when her mother had her, and it was nobody but God that allowed her heart to beat after being declared dead. When she was 3 years old, she had an atrial septal heart defect, which meant she had a hole in the wall that separates the top and bottom chambers from supplying blood to the heart. While in surgery, after they put her heart back into her body, it would not work. They worked for 30 minutes to revive her. When she was 12 years old, she found out she had scoliosis, and the doctors were afraid to have the surgery because of her heart. Even after coding during the operation, God still brought her back. When she was about 15, she was in a truck accident, and the truck flipped 3 times. They didn't know she was in the truck, but they got her out in time, and seconds after, the truck caught on fire. But God. She has had eye restoration because she lost sight in her right eye, and she lost hearing in her right ear. The hardest thing for her was finding out she had uterine and ovarian cancer. She went through 6 months of chemotherapy, and she lost all of her hair. Because it had spread so far, they had to take away her ability to ever have children. She celebrates now because she is now 5 years cancer-free. She has been the mother to me that I never had, and she is truly my hero. I will forever, forever be grateful that God placed her in my life. And now, ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for Ms. Sharwanika Cotton, who will be singing your national anthem today.
Twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watch. Of the free.
Good morning. I'm Mac McCraney. I'm a senior from Hammond High Magnet School, and I was given the opportunity to do the prayer. Can we all bow our heads? Thank you, Lord, for the special gifts of every child as they transition into a new school year. Fill each student with a fresh enthusiasm and a heart that is excited to learn and grow. Cover them with your enduring love, give them confidence and grace, and equip them with the ability to persevere through trials. Bless the teachers with wisdom, understanding, and a heart to serve. Bless the administration as they lead and facilitate. Bless central office as they lead the parish to higher heights. Fill us with love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control as we embark on this journey together. In Jesus' name, amen.
As you get into education, you get into it for the students. And I've said this everywhere I've had the opportunity to talk. One of the greatest things that I've seen, and it's very simple, is when Ms. Stilley took the organizational chart and put the students first. When we started last school year, one of our tasks was we need to get more individuals excited about becoming educators to change the world. It was very simple. We wanted to partner with our local university.
Hello. My name is Carrie Benitez, and I am going to be a senior at LaRonger High School. You may know me as the talkative kid on campus, or you may also know me as the kid that follows along my dad with the giant camera. I'm everywhere, and I know most people in here, and I would just personally like to say thank you if you helped me on my journey to get to where I'm at today. Hammond Eastside, thank you. Thank you, LaRonger High. Thank you to school board members. Thank you to anyone and everyone that has just gotten me to where I am today. Now, something I've learned to value between me and my teachers is a good conversation. I really think communication is important, and I think y'all would agree, between a student and a teacher or an administrator and a teacher. It's something that in this type of field you really need and you really should value. And because of that, I can acknowledge that whenever you go back to school in August, it might be hard to communicate with your students because of the new slang that has happened. And I would like to let you sit back, relax. I'm going to be your friend today, and I'm going to teach you about the slang that has happened in summer of 2019. So the first word I would like to teach you is stan. S-T-A-N, stan. And it means to support something. You can support your school by saying, I stan, then your school. Another word that has happened during the summer of 2019 is cancel, and you don't want to be canceled. It means you used to stand something, you regretted it, and then you decided to simply cancel it. Another word that has happened during summer of 2019 is snatched. Snatched can mean several different things. It simply has a broad connotation, and it adds value to a conversation. Snatched can mean you look amazing right now. You simply look snatched. And that's kind of like the hand motion that goes with it whenever you say it. So you can say, dear principal, I think you really just snatched that meeting. And personally, my favorite word that has happened during summer 2019 is and I oop. Some people may know of and I oop. And it's simply this phrase that you say whenever you are so shocked, you're so surprised, you're simply left speechless to the point that there's nothing else to say except, and a oop. For example, the turnout at this pep rally, it's amazing. I was not expecting this many teachers. I didn't even know we had this many teachers in the parish. And a oop. Now, I would like to change the pace a little bit, and I'm going to introduce you to the next speaker. This speaker is an advocate for children. She works with children of Tangipahoa Parish every day as the 21st District Court Juvenile Judge, a former classroom teacher, and a product of the Tangipahoa Parish system herself. Judge Edwards is an active member of our community, and she's married to our Sheriff Daniel Edwards, and I would just like to shout him out because today is their anniversary. Can we please give them a round of applause? They're spending their anniversary with us, guys. Come on, let's give a warm welcome to this mother of five children and this honorable judge, Judge Blair Edwards.
Well, we're gonna change the pace a little too, and get a little kind of on the serious side so that you can understand how important you guys really are. I read an article in the Los Angeles Times just the other day about the mass shootings. And I know you're thinking, what is she talking about and why is she talking about that here? And I'm going to introduce a lady who's going to go into more of what I'm trying to get across, and she is as well. They did research on all mass shootings since 1966. Do you know what the common similarities between the shooters were? Early childhood trauma. And many of you have heard me say and speak about adverse childhood experiences. That's exactly what they reduced the mass shootings to. Then they go and they talk about, how do we prevent that? What do we do? And another thing that they saw is that in all of these people, there was something that happened before that. Changing behavior, you guys see it, right? Talks of suicide, outbursts, all of those things. They're signs. And then they say, what do we do about it? And not in these words, but what they say is, where do we see most all children? At school. Who makes the most difference in our world today? It's you guys. You teachers make a difference. You will not know if you prevented a mass shooting. You will not know if you prevented a suicide, because many times people don't talk about that. But if you learn to recognize those signs, if you learn to realize that you can be the change in that child's life, our world, our state, our nation will be a much better place.
Now, I promise y'all, you're not having deja vu. It is, in fact, me again, but I had so much to say, they knew they had to cut my time in half. I'm sorry. But I just wanted to mention everyone that I can at least say and attend to that at the dance studio I work at, a little kid comes to me and talks to me about during their school day. Teachers, administration, secretaries, lunchroom workers, bus drivers, nurses, aides, paras, helpers, custodians, parents, and every person who serves a child in the course of a school day, I want to let you know that a little kid comes to me at my dance studio and thanks me or tells me about their great time with you. What you're doing matters, and it's making a difference. Now, something else that I didn't say earlier is that I'm NHS president of La Rondra High School. And NHS is a club, in case you don't know, that is for academic students, and you have to hold a certain GPA to hold it, but also you have to be accepted after writing an essay, because it's also about morals. Not anyone with good grades can just get into NHS. Someone who is morally right and holds a good character for themselves is able to enter the club. Well, in order to get into the club, you have to represent four pillars, and these pillars are scholarship, service, leadership, and character. And I'm so happy to be able to introduce you to someone that I believe not only holds these four pillars in his heart, but he uses them every day at his job in order to make this community a great one. Now, please help me in giving a warm welcome to Sheriff Daniel Edwards.
So y'all got the feeling yet?
What a beautiful and great day. And it starts first because it's an anniversary for my wife and I. So thank you, Blair, for putting up with me for, I think it's 23. I can, Gary Stanger, can you check at the clerk's office? I think it's 23. But it's also a beautiful day to be here. And it started off also with probably the best national anthem I've ever heard sung by Miss Cotton. I want to say to all of you teachers, the support staff, to our superintendent, you know, you probably know I'm a public school supporter. I'm a huge believer in this school system. Not only did you equip me to be prepared to go out into the world, my wife, our judge is a product of this school system as well, but I happen to know a couple other people called the governor and first lady who came up through this school system. And I think you prepared them pretty well too, because I think they're doing a heck of a job as well. So. To Miss Liz, thank you so much for coming and sharing your story. Thank you as well for sharing a supper with Blair and I last night. And want you to know, she does get to travel a good bit in her job. She gets to eat at some good restaurants. We took her to the steakhouse last night, and she will tell you that was as good of a steak as she's ever had, right here in Tangipahoa Parish, Louisiana. To Ms. Stilley, to this whole school system, I want you to know, as your sheriff and our department, we're extremely proud to partner with you in everything that we do, whether it's our DARE program, whether it's help serving the truancy notices, whether it's teaching training about, you know, active shooter courses, our SRO program, whatever it is, we're proud to partner with our school system, because together we are stronger. I look forward to continuing that partnership to help make your job better, to help make our parish stronger. I want to end by just saying this. I know you have a tough job. You know that you have an important job. You touch people's lives. You change people's lives. I thank you for what you do. I want you to have a happy year. I want you to have a successful year. And I just want to say thank you, and God bless you to each and every one of you.
Well, thank you, Sheriff. I greatly appreciate that. It's good to have friends in office, and Gary's here, Junior Matthew went in, both of those guys are unopposed too, so we have a good crew coming back. Is that right, Kerry? What a great day. It's not just a feeling that we're going to have a great year, it's a proclamation we're going to have a great year. As parish president, I get to run all over the parish. I get to go all over the state. And I can tell you, I know for a fact that we live in the very best parish in the state of Louisiana. And the reason why I know that, and the reason why I can tell you that, is because of you. Because of the people who live here, work here, play here, and raise their families here. We come together when we need to. Look at this crowd. We take care of every facet of the school system in this group right here, and y'all do a phenomenal job for our citizens, for our children. Whenever we go through the things that we did in 16 with the floods, you were there. When we go through needing to pave a parking lot so we can add more parking places, we're there. You're there to make sure that we know what to do and how to do it for you. But more importantly, all the message that Miss Liz, you gave, and I got to say, and I oop there too. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Whenever you had that little blonde-headed, blue-eyed boy in the fourth grade that couldn't read, you made sure that he could, and that was me. When you had that little blonde-headed, blue-eyed boy that would run around the classroom and probably needed to be on 16 different kind of medicines or whatever it was, you made sure that I didn't. That I stayed there and I got through. So I thank you, because without your help, without a teacher's help, without an administration and a support staff, there's a chance I wouldn't be standing here. But I thank you for loving on us. I thank you for taking care of us. I thank you for recognizing that we've only had one perfect person to ever walk on this earth, and we nailed him to a cross. I hope y'all have the best year ever in the best parish in the state, and that everything is perfect all year long. Thank you so much.
Teachers, not only those in a traditional classroom, impact the lives of children in many ways. For every child, his influence is different, but it ultimately involves support and motivation. The simple act of me standing here today is a perfect example of this. A prestigious community member and personal mentor of mine, Mr. Lamar Marshall, motivated me to be a risk taker and attain this moment of achievement in my life. For those of you who don't know me, I am by nature incredibly shy and have turned down numerous opportunities for public speaking. But Mr. Marshall made me believe that I am capable. However, it wasn't his lone advice that got me to this stage. He was simply the final word of encouragement following many other influential educators in my life. While Mr. Marshall is an example of how anyone can step into the role of educator and encourager, I've also had many traditional classroom teachers that have helped me mold me into the person I am today. My English teachers, Ms. Duncan and Ms. Bankston, did not only teach me proper writing etiquette, but they have also pushed me to be a well-rounded, balanced student and person. Ms. Duncan has offered me encouragement that continuously helps push me toward reaching my full potential, while Ms. Bankston simply made me more confident in myself and my capabilities by consistently cheering me on. Together, they helped guide me to my decision of pursuing the full IB diploma. When I doubted my ability, they reminded me of my talents and my accomplishments. Their positive and encouraging words remained in my mind as I continued my high school journey. From these positive influences in my life, I have learned that simple, kind words and motivation can make a long-term difference. I continue to keep it to my mind every day as I strive to push my peers to achieve everything I know they can, even if they do not believe so themselves. Because I've learned that I, as well as you, have a responsibility to pass on what has been taught to me. I am to inspire those around me just as my teachers inspired me. So remember, be respectful, be compassionate, and be great.
Enviro Mechanical is ready to handle all of your air conditioning and refrigeration needs. Enviro is a train and carrier dealer and services all makes and models. Financing is no problem. Enviro offers inexpensive annual maintenance memberships and now has an $85 tune-up special. So if you're in need of a great deal and a good system, or just a quick repair, call Enviro at 855-403-COOL.